How difficult is it for Tehelka to survive after that initial shock with the NDA?
Well, the first 5 years were really difficult. We didn't survive to begin with. We were shut down by the NDA government. Mm-hmm. We went down from a team of 125 people to 5 people.
Wow.
And the website closed down, everything closed down, the offices went. So for 3.5 years, we were pretty much in the wilderness, basically battling the government propaganda, the commission of inquiry, the cases, the dummy cases that we put against us. We came back in 2004 as a weekly, and it's been a huge battle since then to survive. It's much better now.
So has your perception of news changed? Did that experience at any point make say, you know what, maybe you can't go into this battle all guns blazing?
No, I don't think so. I think it did the contrary, in fact. I think the Tehelka experience was a deepening experience. First of all, it took me away from the zone of comfort that most English journalism in India exists in.
Which is
most of us are born into a cocoon in India. Most of us of our class, your class and my class. And I think the idea of understanding Indian democracy, I think, doesn't come to most of us for a very long time.
Do you think most of English journalism isn't representative that way of much of
India? Yeah, because at the end of the day, it's kind of run largely by people who come from a certain privileged class background. So the idea of India is a very sanitized one. I think what the Tehelka experience did for us was that we were swallowed by the beast. So we went into the belly of the beast. And I think for me, the 17 years of journalism I had done before Tehelka, whereas nothing compared to those 3 years of battling the government, because I began to understand the true nature of Indian democracy, of India, of what we are really up against, the real issues at play.
You're saying nothing has changed, you don't feel that a certain amount of compromise will have to be made, one can't have such a puritanical view of governance, of industry.
No, I'm saying exactly the opposite. I'm saying the experience of Tehelka taught me what the real issues in this country are, how complex this country is, and how for all these years, fundamentally, me and people of my class live in a bit of a cocoon. They have a very sanitized view of things. They even don't even begin to understand how layered and complex the issues are. And I think that became very obvious to me then. And that's why, in a sense, Tehelka journalism is always more layered and complex than everybody. It's largely because of what we live through.
And journalism in general, what is your view of it in India? Because it's going through a hard patch where everybody says that
it's a mixed bag. There's good and bad in it. I think where it fails us is that it fails to convey the framework and complexities within which the Indian democracy plays itself out. You know, so there's a kind of
there's
kind of easy binaries in which most of Indian journalism works, good and bad, right and wrong, and the binary shifts by the moment, by the day. You know, it doesn't allow for deeper understandings. Yeah, you know, it allows bigotries to flourish. The good news is that we have so much media that the biases cancel themselves out, you know. And even the compromises, that all of Indian media is compromised, if you look at it from some kind of a pure perspective.
Sure.
But you know, I mean, pure perspectives in themselves are scary.